to Simple Soyman!
Yes! I can't wait to see how tofu is made!
I hope you brought your hairnet!
I did! I love wearing my hairnet! Everyone loves it when I wear my hairnet.
Okay, let's go see RJ and Barb at Simple Soyman.
Alright, here we go! Woo!
And here we are at Simple Soyman, where the beans have been soaking overnight. Here's RJ, one of the co-founders of Simple Soyman, who's putting the beans into the grinder. After the beans go through the grinder, they go through three boiler systems and then get pumped into a centrifugal extractor that spits out the bean pulp called okara and the soy milk on the other side. To separate the liquid from the curds, nagari, a vegetarian curding agent, is added on its path to becoming tofu. Nagari, by the way, has all the mineral components of seawater except for the salt. After the second addition of nagari, the liquid is removed and the curds are put into tofu boxes to set and be pressed. Tofu making equipment is kind of hard to find. These presses came from the Magic Bean, which was Milwaukee's first tofu making company. Most companies pasteurize their tofu to extend the shelf life. Simple Soyman does not, so its tofu is truly fresh. Some people also think that tofu is fermented, but it's not. The only fermented tofu product that Simple Soyman makes is their delicious tempeh. But that's a whole different YouTube video. After a half hour pressing, the tofu is removed from the boxes and taken to the cutting table, where it's divided into smaller blocks that you can purchase at Outpost Natural Foods. The blocks then go into the cold water tank, supplied with continuously running fresh water before getting packaged. If the tofu is too soft to get cut, it gets saved for use in other delicious products like tofu pate, hummus, and saucy joe, to name a few. Simple Soyman packages their tofu under the Bountiful Bean and Simple Soyman labels. Now let's talk to Barb and hear how she and RJ got started.
So tell me how you came to dedicate your life to making tofu.
Well, back in the 70s, we were some hungry vegetarians, and there weren't a lot of convenience foods on the market. Mm-hmm. So RJ and I had volunteered for Outpost for one of the meals committees, and for this most beautiful fair, we made tofu sloppy joes. And everybody liked them so much, we decided to make them and sell them at Outpost. Called them Saucy Joe, mm-hmm. not to be confused with the meat kind.
Mm-hmm.
And we were buying our tofu from the Magic Bean. Well, shortly after that, the Magic Bean went out of business, and there was no tofu. So we needed to start making tofu to make for our own products.
Do you have to do a lot of marketing of yourselves, or do people come to find you since you were the only tofu in the area?
Well, we don't do a lot of advertising.
No.
We pretty much rely on word of mouth.
Mm-hmm.
Don't
That's think. How it's been for 25 years, pretty much?
Right, the whole time. We just slowly added more products, mm-hmm. made more things out of tofu toaster burgers, mm-hmm. tofu turkey, you know, just branched out into other areas mm-hmm. of tofu products. And mostly relied on word of mouth. We have a good quality product, and people tell each other.
Mm-hmm. And when kids came along, was it just sort of a family, the kids were surrounded by this all the time, they've grown up?
Both of our children spent their first years
mm-hmm.
at the shop.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they help out on days off, they help their dad do deliveries on Fridays, and they have a lot of fun. Yeah, tofu.
Nice. Tofu's your family.
Yeah,
yeah.
At least for now.
Thanks to Barb and RJ and the Simple Soyman crew for showing us how tofu is made. Knock on the front door.